Renewable energy sources are the future. The challenge is to make our electricity grids flexible and resilient. In an effort to reshape the energy landscape, European scientists have joined forces in the ambitious Ebalance Plus project. With experts from Spain, France, Italy and beyond, they aim to support our changing use of electricity based on renewables.
This is important that people year by year understand that this is the only way to manage the future, because the grid is facing many problems in the future when everybody adopts renewable energy, adopts electric vehicle, because the grid don't have the capability, the capacity to support all this power to supply to all the users. So these kind of mechanisms of flexibility are necessary to balance.
After 4 years of EU-funded research and testing, the Ebalance Plus project has shown remarkable success in revolutionizing our energy grids. This has been achieved with the help of four real-life pilots and a digital demonstrator to simulate the effects of integrating innovative technologies. Thus, the project contributes relevant insights for the recent EU Action Plan for Grids. In Spain, the project partners set up vehicle-to-grid charging points connected to a photovoltaic canopy, as well as the university's local grid, smart batteries and an easy-to-use mobile app.
You can use the car as battery and charge and recharge. The Ampere smart battery is used to store energy in the cheaper hours and use that in the future during the peak hour or more expensive hour.
This setup demonstrates that it is possible to achieve grid independence on a local level. End customers play a key role in this. They need to be involved and participate alongside the energy suppliers and distributors.
I think most of the people don't care about being part of the grid because they only care about having a plug at home to use the electricity. But for people having electric cars, it's a bit different because they are concerned about the use of the electricity because they have to care about how to charge the car.
Empowering people and including the end consumer in energy transition processes is crucial. At the University of Calabria, Italy, the researchers involve students in managing energy consumption of their smart devices using a mobile app, thus contributing to a sustainable future.
These devices have really changed the way I thought about energy use, not only because they allow you to manage energy very efficiently with the timers that they have, but also because they have systems that allow you to visualize the energy consumption of each device connected to them.
The university consumes 8 megawatts of connection power. To meet this high demand, they installed renewable energy plants. But there's still a long way to go to achieve grid independence.
Today, the University of Calabria has installed various renewable energy systems, from geothermal to solar concentration and photovoltaic systems.
The researchers have deployed smart meter devices and balanced the grid with the help of monitoring and control systems.
Thanks to this monitoring system, we are able to observe our microgrid in real time. We are able to see the different powers exchanged with the grid and the exchange power produced by the photovoltaic system.
In addition to managing local grids, the researchers improved energy management in buildings, paying attention to every aspect, including renewable energy production, smart grid technology, and the end consumer. Their challenge? Demonstrate these innovative grid technologies in existing buildings.
One of the first questions at the beginning of the project was, is it possible to deploy flexibility mechanisms in existing buildings, existing facilities? With new technology, everybody knows that 40% of the energy consumption in Europe comes from the residential building or the building sector. So imagine if we can deploy flexibility mechanisms in the residential side, we are controlling more or less the 30% of the energy in the European Union. So we are in position to accelerate the decarbonization of the European Union.
At the Catholic University of Lille, France, founded in 1885, the researchers proved exactly this. They equipped three old buildings with several measuring tools, set up a photovoltaic system, and installed devices to enable communication between the different energy networks.
The obvious goal for our buildings is to be carbon neutral. We are trying to use renewable energies and to minimize our consumption. We outfitted the different buildings so as to reduce our consumption and to be as independent of the grid as possible.
The entire energy system is operated using the control unit in the basement of the university.
The system collects all the information on databases. We have developed an interface called an API, which allows us to exchange data in complete security with the various partners, and the partners are able to send us instructions how to reduce our electricity consumption, and thus to bring flexibility to the electricity network.
Project partners have not only looked at old buildings. In Denmark, they focused on summer houses. The swimming pools in these houses were used as thermal storage to provide flexibility to the grid. The results of the various demonstration sites contribute to achieving the European 2030 climate and energy objectives.
The good point of our project is that most of the devices, the hardware that we have developed, will be introduced in the market soon.
Ebalance Plus, shaping a future in which energy flexibility, resilience, and sustainability drive our communities.